Virtual reality is happening and it is going crazy. When Facebook bought the virtual reality headset maker Oculus Rift for $2 billion this year, it made sure that this is the future of computing. Other internet behemoths like Google and electronic majors like Samsung and even the automobile manufacturing are heavily investing in virtual reality. So how can Hershey fit into this puzzle? How could Hershey leverage this virtual reality scope to reinvent itself for the digital world in delivering amazing experiences? We decided to tackle this problem with an IoT Arduino-based atomizer that will help exponentially increase in delivering the Hershey experience of eating a chocolate without actually eating it. So what is an experience? An experience is just a feedback of all the sensory pleasures that you experience that is getting pushed into your brain. So this leaves us with five senses and this inherent feel-good factor that you get when you eat a chocolate because of the change in your bodily biochemistry. Virtual reality headset almost takes care of all your biosensors, but the only thing that is left underrated is your sense of smell, and that is a really unaddressed segment for all the virtual reality headset users. We created a simple prototype to explain our idea. The prototype involves creating a simple swing-based tic-tac-toe game, except instead of O's and X, we have a Hershey and a potato playing each other. So every time you win a series of Hershey chocolates, you get a signal passed to the Arduino, which then triggers the atomizer. So you win a game digitally, you get the experience in real world because of the atomizer. So as you could see in this class, we have a port name, which is actually the slot at which you connect the Arduino's USB cable into your PC. Usually in this case, it is COM11 where it is connected. So in order to build the game, we need a NARXTX Java library, which actually helps in communicating software with hardware, in this case the Arduino board. So we could communicate between our Eclipse IDE and the Arduino by passing values through the serial connection, which in this case is just a USB cable. Within the six exponential technologies that Singularity University believes in, the Internet of Things and the virtual reality are the two ideas that are closest in reaching the market earlier. Gaming is really an attractive domain within the whole virtual reality world. You could run the Java application, the game as such now. You could win the game and it would ask a flag if you really want to run the atomizer now. If you want, you could then say yes or one, which is true. Then the Arduino takes it up and makes the atomizer work. But now you can't send it to the port because the Arduino is not actually connected to the PC. So it just says no port is available as of now, so you can't send the value anywhere now. So once we connect the Arduino board to this game, so the serial port will be available, and that value will then get passed to the Arduino. Then the whole hardware part actually comes into the picture, which we'll actually discuss it in a minute. On the hardware side, to build the atomizer, we need an Arduino Uno, a Hitox servo, an arm for the servo, a battery pack, a breadboard, and a few jumper wires to connect them in a breadboard and have it in the common ground. And for the atomizer, we need an ordinary spray with pinholes on its side and a big hole for the sprayer to spray, and a rod with a king to trigger the atomizer every time the servo pushes it, and tape it all around with the servo on the top, and so that it has one integratable body. We should also download the Arduino IDE from the Arduino website and use that to set up experiments before we actually have the setup together. I am actually passing a signal via digital pin 8 on the Arduino Uno to the servo, and use a battery pack for the power supply and ground for the servo. So what you see now is the final setup for the atomizer. I am using a 360 degree servo but for high torque, but we could normally use a 180 degree servo, but the torque is way lesser. So however, I do have a workaround to pull the trigger for when it rotates in a 360 degree. And coming to the Arduino programming part of it, I'm using a 360 degree server, as I said, so it doesn't really make sense now, as you see, to have right positions on 180 degree on it. But if you are using a 180 degree server, this code should help. And based on the values that you get, you could specify position or make the server to stop. So after you're done with your programming part in the server, you could compile the code and see if there are any issues with the coding part of it. So once you're done with the compilation part, now you could directly upload your Arduino code into your Uno board and connect it to the power supply, and let's see how the trials work. What I've created now is a simple 2D tic-tac-toe game, but imagine if Hershey could partner with other gaming firms like Minecraft to reinvent games like Candy Crush and replace identity or brandless candies which they currently have with the candy like Hershey, a digital format of it. And every time you score a digital Hershey, an atomizer get triggered in the real world with a Hershey flavor. So this helps in delivering the Hershey experience without actually eating the chocolate. And this could be extended to other games like Heyday as well, or any other game that rewards users with chocolates, or any rewards for that case.